I want to de-Google and de-Microsoft my life. And as much as possible, I'd like to move over to open source software for the apps that I'm currently using. I started thinking about this a few months ago, and I got in that phase of maybe I'll do it, maybe I won't, it's not that big of a deal. And because YouTube and all social media just knows what I'm thinking, even if I don't say it out loud, YouTube started recommending stuff to me about switching to Linux in the algorithm, and I thought, well, may as well just check out some stuff. And the more I watched, the more interested I got, and eventually I got to PewDiePie's videos, the ones where he installed Linux on his computer, as well as where he went all open source with stuff and started self-hosting. And those videos were the most encouraging because he admitted that he's not super technical and he was able to figure it out. And as somebody who is a little bit technical, it is still a little bit daunting going to a completely different operating system I've never used before and trying to figure all this stuff out on my own. But after watching those videos, I went from thinking, maybe I'll do this one day, to I want to start this today. My main priority is privacy, because I've always been a staunch advocate for people to not just remove the doors from every digital house they own so every company can know whether or not they had corn in their shit this morning. And more, it just feels like companies want to know everything there is to know about me, and they will do anything it takes to get that info, even if it means scanning my emails or taking pictures of my desktop for some reason. It's really gross, kind of creepy, and very dehumanizing. As far as these companies are concerned, I am just user 77543. I'm a dataset, I'm a dollar sign, I'm a way for them to make money. And I don't like that at all. So I want to make changes in my life that go beyond just Googling myself every once in a while to see what's out there and what I should probably remove from the internet. Then, like I said, my second priority is open source. I don't need everything to be open source, but if it could be, that'd be great. I'm definitely not going to go and review every bit of code that there is, but knowing that there is a community of people who will do that and report whether or not there's something sus in this code makes me feel warm and fuzzy on the inside. Because all I need is a browser that browses. All I need is an operating system that operates. I don't need Google wondering if I need a psychiatrist or if I just like death metal. So this is going to be a video journey of that process, and I need your help, because I've been using Microsoft my entire life. I've never had a computer that did not have Windows on it. I'm running Windows 10 right now on my computer because that feels kind of like being anally probed with an index finger, and I'm going to keep it that way until I have to switch to Windows 11, because Windows 11 feels like being anally fisted with no lube when they're trying to get my dental records. Windows 11 is literally spyware, and the longer I go without using it, the better. Linux is the end goal, but I can't make that switch just yet, which I'll talk about in just a bit. As far as Google is concerned, they also hold a pretty big piece of the pie of my data. I use their web browser, their email services, their documents, their Drive, and of course their search engine. Truthfully, the reason that I use Google for that stuff is because up until now, I just was kind of under the impression that all the other options were not good and you shouldn't use them. Because in my head, I'll still think of like Yahoo and Hotmail for email and stuff like Ask Jeeves for search engines. But in the little bit of research that I've done so far, it seems like the internet has grown up a lot and there's probably some really good alternatives to Google and Microsoft for the things that I need. And that is the reason I need your help, because I don't know what's out there. I'm going to be doing as much research as I can to find the stuff that works for me, but having another source, another opinion definitely helps. So I want your suggestions, I want your help, and I want to know your story. What was the nail in the coffin for Google and Microsoft for you? What made you want to switch to different services? And if you're on Linux, what made you want to go to that? Because the more I read about people taking control of their privacy again, it just adds to the fuel tank of me wanting to do this more and more. With all that said though, what is the end goal for me? What do I want and what are my use cases? Firstly, gaming. Secondly, production, so like video, audio, and photo editing. And third, just general stuff like web browsing or just basic stuff for work. So with that in mind, let's talk about my switch from Windows to Linux, because I don't know if I can do that just yet. I don't want to just make the change without testing anything. I do want to make sure that the things that I need are actually going to work on Linux if I go there. But also, ideally, I'd like to have apps that also work on Windows, so when I make that change, I'm not figuring stuff out for the first time on Linux. I do have a laptop I can install Linux on, but I don't really use it a whole lot, and I would prefer to have a computer that I'm actually going to be using somewhat regularly so I can actually test Linux and see how it works, how it functions, how all this stuff operates. But yeah, I don't know, I might do it on my laptop. I'm just still not sure. I don't know if I should just make the jump to Linux and then deal with it, or just use that laptop and then at the very least just test stuff and then move over. So with all that in mind, what I've started with is I made an Excel doc, which is ironic given this video. And I've made a list of all the apps I have currently installed and all the games I play and have played in the past. And the way that I have it set up is column A is all the apps that I currently have on my computer. Column B is whether or not those apps can by themselves run on Linux. Column C is for the open source alternative for those apps, if there is one, if it's not also already open source. Column D is whether or not that open source alternative works on Linux. And then column E is the app that I would end up using on Linux once I switch. The ideal situation is column C and E will match. After that, I have column G, which is all the games that I currently have installed or tend to reinstall from time to time. Column H is whether or not those games will work out of the box on Linux without any extra setup. And then column I is whether or not, in general, those games can be run on Linux. Like, I imagine some of the Battlefield games there are just not going to run at all because of anti-cheat. So that's a lot of research I have to do, but I want to make changes today. So my primary goal right now is figuring out some of the easy things. Right now, I use Chrome, Edge, and Firefox for my browsers, so I want to see what can I switch to, like, after this video. In the little bit of research I've done, it seems that Brave and Vivaldi are probably the front runners. I also want to take a look at my mail service and figure out where I can create a new email and start moving all my accounts over to. After a little bit of research, again, it feels like Proton Mail is probably the best one here, but there is like limited features on the free version and I don't really want to pay for my mail, so we'll see what other options there are. As a content creator, I want to ditch Photoshop. I think that GIMP is the alternative here for me. Sony Vegas is the video editor I've been using for probably like 20 years now, and it in general is awful, so I'd like to switch to something else. But for that one, I might just go to DaVinci Resolve because it's free and it seems to be very good, so I'll check that out. But yeah, this is where the journey begins. Part 2 will be in the description whenever it comes out. If it still says coming soon, that's because I'm living part 2 right now. This series is going to be kind of like a vlog. I don't know when the next part will be out, but hopefully not too long. You can definitely subscribe if you want to know when the next video will be out, though this is primarily a gaming channel, not a tech channel, so if you're not into that sort of thing, you don't have to. I am judging you pretty harshly though, so it's up to you. If you don't subscribe, if you like this video, at least give it a thumbs up, because when part 2 does come out, I imagine YouTube will just serve that up in your algorithm. So it is time to get started. I am very excited about this, and I'm very curious to see how the next probably few months will pan out. Whether you're here for the journey or just here for this video, I appreciate you so much. Thank you for tuning in. The description box has all of my social media, so if you're interested in that, check it out. I'll see you in the next one, or I won't. Thanks for watching. I love you. Bye.